art. 2. Now make it.
Hey guys, welcome to Art 2. If you're new to the channel, we discuss ways to sell your art online. And in today's video, we're discussing how to sell sports-related designs on Redbubble without having your account banned for using copyrighted sports images, such as team logos, leagues, or players. So let's get into it on how some people make money on Redbubble selling sports-themed designs without breaking copyright laws. So hey guys, there's a lot of ways to sell sports-related designs on Redbubble without having to break copyright laws by taking logos and designs from professional teams. And you can make a lot of money with sports designs and not get banned from Redbubble if you are smart at the way that you design your sports related designs. So let's get into it and find out how some people are selling sports related designs and doing really well with them on Redbubble. So when I want to get into a certain category of designs on Redbubble, I always do some research and see what's already on the platform to make sure that I'm not copying or that I can be inspired by some of the designs that I see. So in this case, I actually typed in football and started to go through the Redbubble search and see what came up for football. So when I looked through this category and this particular keyword, I found that there was a lot of designs that were copyrighted, and it looked like these people had just taken the logo straight off some other website and uploaded it to Redbubble. You can't do that. That's breaking copyright, and it's going to get you banned at some point from selling on Redbubble, and you don't want to have that happen. So don't chase the quick sales. Come up with original designs. Like, some of the designs that I found in this category or under this keyword for football were people that had taken scores, the scoreboard with the abbreviated names of the teams. That way they couldn't get in trouble for having the team name or logo or anything like that in their design, and it was kind of a cool, catchy design that would probably sell on Redbubble. This is a way to get around these technicalities of sports teams. So if you think outside the box, you can find designs to sell on Redbubble that don't break copyright and still capture some of the essence of that team or that sports league, whatever it might be that you're going after. So let's look at a few other designs in different sports and see if we can come up with some ideas for your designs. Okay, so the first step is to actually pick a sport that you want to create a design around and then start doing some research on Redbubble and see what other people have been uploading for that sport. So we looked at some of the football designs and we saw that there are some official logos that people did actually copy and upload to Redbubble, which is a no-no. And then we saw how some people were a little bit creative and added different components to the logos to make it look different enough that they couldn't get in trouble or would be able to avoid being banned altogether from the platform. So from my interaction with other users on Redbubble, I do know of some people that have incorporated designs that look very similar to the logo for the sports team or the league, and have the copyright holders request that their design be taken down by Redbubble, and Redbubble has complied. But the thing is that they were different enough that when they appealed the decision, they were able to get their designs back onto Redbubble. So you're really at the mercy of Redbubble, and that they see a big enough difference in the design that you uploaded and what is being requested to be taken down. So I personally would not want to actually upload anything that looks like a copyrighted logo, and I've been saying this through the whole video because I know that it's going to lead to trouble going forward. These leagues, these sports teams, they spend a lot of money marketing their brand, and they don't want you to go on Redbubble and upload something similar and make money off this platform when they are putting a lot of investment into the brand that they own. So I would say that if you're going to make a design, try to work loosely around the team, try to work loosely around the league, and try to put maybe sayings or certain things that might indicate that you're supporting the team, but don't necessarily use anything that you think might be copyrighted. So a great example of t-shirt design from the past that sold really well over the years is when you look at large box stores like Walmart or Target. They sell a lot of non-branded sports-related merchandise as far as clothing goes and things along those lines, where they'll take a graphic of a sport for soccer or football, come up with a catchy little slogan, and throw it on a t-shirt. And those usually sell in large volumes in these stores, and they're not in any way related to any of the teams, leagues, or players. So you can sell designs without having to be infringing on copyright. So I really want you guys to focus on creating original designs around the sports that you love, because if somebody likes that sport, they don't necessarily need to have the team logo. It's generic, it's open to everybody who likes that sport. So hey guys, I hope this has inspired you to create sports designs and not to be afraid to upload sports designs that are original to Redbubble. You'll be safe, you'll make money, but just be on the cautious side when you upload things that might be tipping the copyright laws, because you don't want to get banned from this platform. So if you guys like this type of content, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you know when the next video goes up. And if you hit the like button, that helps us get found in the YouTube algorithm. So we'll see you guys in the next one. Keep creating, keep uploading, and we'll give you more tips on how to sell art on print-on-demand sites like Redbubble. And we're going to add more different platforms as we go forward with this channel. So don't forget to subscribe and come back. We'll talk to you guys later. Have a good day.